Now, first off, who in here is a Christian?
No.
Good, we have some believers in here. Now, for you non-believers, this story is for you. Now, when I was little and back in kindergarten, I was just a little one at a different church, and in Sunday school, we learned how to accept Jesus into our heart. We learned how to pray, that it's good to pray, and that before you can accept Jesus into your heart, you have to accept that he is your Savior, and that you believe he really did come down from heaven and put himself on the cross for everyone in here.
Yeah, I didn't believe that.
So what happened was, when I was little, I went into my room, got into a space corner, and I prayed to God that I believe in him, that he is my Savior and everyone else in the world, and that he's the one who died on the cross for my sins, your sins, and everyone in the world's sins. Now, after I did that, there you have baptism in the church, and you really don't have to have that, but that's just what they do. Like, they get freshly clean water to put you down, and what that does is says that you want to be just like Jesus. But one thing is here.
You have to get saved first.
Yes, that's one thing. And also another thing is that just because you ask Jesus into your heart doesn't mean that you can't lie anymore. It's bad to lie, but still, no one's perfect.